Hey, what's up guys? It's Asigo here, and we are back in Crysis 2 multiplayer. So once again, this is instant action, or also known as deathmatch for you guys. So I mainly wanted to talk about my experience with playing Crysis 2 for the past 2 weeks. And this goes mainly for the multiplayer side. I will do a different video talking about the single player aspect, but I was most into this game for the multiplayer. So, back in 2011, when they had the demo released, there were two versions. The first one only had Skyline, and then they made an update, and then that demo had Skyline and Pier 17. So, when I played the demo, I was like, well, it seems alright. It might just be like an okay game. I didn't think at the time that the game would be like some big blockbuster. Which, in turn, it didn't really turn out to be a big blockbuster title compared to other games. But that's alright. So the thing is, when I was playing it back then in the demo, I was like, well, I think the game might have some problems with the whole invisibility thing. Like, back then, and some videos after that, I was saying, like, the game might have the problem where people turn invisible and they just want to sit in corners and they don't want to move. But after playing the game all the way up to the end of the ranks, I think that it's the opposite. Because after playing it so long, I really find that the game is more based on rushdown compared to camping. Like, when I look at my experience with Call of Duty, that game has more people that would sit in corners and just wait in a room for you compared to this game. When I really thought this game would have a bigger problem with campers or people sitting in corners or people who don't move, you know? But after playing it for 2 weeks, I really do like the game. I can say it is one of my favorite first-person shooters, and I'm going to continue to play it even when I finish the multiplayer ranks, which is 50. I might go back and try to maybe do some challenges on some shitty guns that I find I'm really bad at. For one of them is the MK60 light machine gun. It's got a really big clip of 100 bullets, but I find the gun is like really weak for some reason, and the accuracy is really shit. So it's a really hard gun to get like consistent kills with compared to when I used the SCAR or the Scarab. And shortly after that, I was using the Feline SMG, but I find the Feline was a little bit weak, even though you kind of sacrifice damage for a bit more mobility. But anyways, so like I said, looking back at when I first tried the demo, I was thinking the game was going to have problems with the invisibility and people just sitting in corners and not moving. But yeah, it is the opposite, really. Like, because I find there's more people running around trying to get kills than compared to those who will sit in a corner. Because the majority are always running around trying to find people. Whereas the maps are kind of big in a way, but they're suitable for 12 players in deathmatch. Because I think that's the max limit they have in ranked. So what I do find is design of the maps, they kind of benefit people who would sit in corners, but I just find that people just don't do that. Like, they don't want to sit there because more people are running around, I'd say during like the middle of the map, around there. No one really goes to the outskirts and checks corners, really. You know, that's something you would do in Call of Duty, but not in this game. So I really had a lot of fun playing Crysis 2 multiplayer, and the funny thing is, when I picked it up, I immediately hopped into multiplayer because I want to get into it. And the thing is, I played the multiplayer up until like I think rank 45 or 46, and then finally I went to single player. I thought, alright, I know it enough, now I'll pop into single player and see what it's like. So I'm going to save my thoughts on the single player portion for a different video. And I'll let you guys know what I think about that portion of the game. But the multiplayer was really fun. I really like it. Mind you, I think some of the modules are a little bit underpowered. Like, they're not as useful. Like, for example, you know, the obvious one, the air stomp, like I mentioned many times. The air stomp in multiplayer is more like a fun gimmick. It's not something that really should replace the other modules in the same tier. What was the other one? The one that you can actually track footsteps by a nearby opponent. I don't really see myself using that. I tried it a little bit, but I found it's just not for me. It's something I think more cautious players would use, you know, not rush players. But what was the other one? The one where you don't make any sound on your footsteps. There's also another one you can carry your primary weapon on your back as your secondary, so you can have two primary weapons. There's another one that can reduce the recoil on your gun as you're firing, but I guess this is only when you're aiming down your sights. I used it up until level 3 and it was alright, but then after I got the XP, I didn't find myself using it anymore really. So I think there's a few more, but I can't remember off the top of my head. But the point is, I think some of these modules just don't really seem as good as others, and it makes you wonder why use a weaker one when you can use a better one that can actually help you get more kills, you know. But it also depends on, I guess, the way you play, you know, the way you strategize yourself through multiplayer. Some people are rushed down, some people are defensive, you know, stuff like that. I have not used the sniper rifles at all. It's like, I'm not good with snipers anyway, so I just won't bother with it. I tried the automatic shotgun. It was alright, but I'm usually not a shotgun player, even if it's an automatic. So, the multiplayer is really fun. I was surprised that in ranked matches, people are still playing this game, and this goes for team deathmatch and deathmatch alone. And recently, I was trying Crash Site with a friend of mine, and we actually got into quite a few games, like especially in the same lobby, we always had a good amount of people in Crash Site. But it seems the other game modes, I think the other three or so, are completely abandoned. No one seems to play that anymore. So if you guys are looking into Crysis 2 on Xbox 360, you should get it for a low price of maybe 15, 20 bucks. No, that price is reasonable for the game, and there's still a good amount of people playing the game and ranked matches. So you really shouldn't have any problem leveling up your character here. So, but I think so far, instant action or deathmatch or free-for-all, however you want to see it, that is my favorite game mode so far. I tend to do much better when I'm playing solo compared to when I'm playing for another team or with another team. That's just the way I've always been, I guess, when I'm playing first-person shooters. Like, I'll play with friends, but I'm more focused on getting my own kills than, than worrying about the entire team, you know? But anyways, so this has been the end of another Crysis 2 multiplayer match. So if you guys got any thoughts on this, just let me know in the comment section. So thanks for watching, guys. Have a good day, and I'll see you guys later on.